Tell us about your show. How did it go? Was it your first show, your second show, your third show? What did you place? How did it feel? The whole nine yards. Spill it out.
Let's see. It was my fourth competition, and it was my first pro show. So I went pro after three shows, and then did my fourth pro show, still not knowing anything. It was only my fourth time. But it was an awesome experience. I was the youngest guy up there.
How old are you?
25.
Shit.
Yeah, I knew I was going to be the youngest guy up there. I knew I was going to be one of the smallest guys up there.
You were one of the smallest guys up there? Were you actually?
Yeah.
Well, are you serious?
Yeah, well,
that's ridiculous.
You're tall. Being a taller dude, it takes a lot longer to fill out a frame than it does a shorter person. You know, I came in, so my last competition was 2 years ago. I was 217 on stage. And then this couple weeks ago at this show, I was 260 on stage. So I put on over 40 pounds of freaking muscle in 2 years. It's crazy seeing that. I was, you know, I went through the police academy. I wasn't solely about bodybuilding, but I think that break and just not focusing like just on lifting weights is what actually helped me. But anyway, yeah, it was crazy because I was back there with people that I've watched my whole life. You know, I watched Johnny Jackson and Branch Warren's videos my whole life and how they train. And that's part of the reason of how I train, just watching how intense they are. So it was surreal seeing him backstage, pumping up with him. And, you know, they say well, your idols become your rivals. It's like, it's just a crazy, crazy feeling, man. But I didn't do terrible. I did pretty much exactly how I thought I was gonna do.
Which is?
I mean, I placed like 16th out of like 20-something guys, but I still beat, you know, six other professional athletes, which, like, you know, at my age, I'm pretty happy with that.
No small feat, for sure.
Yeah. So now I've just got to focus on getting bigger and get ready for next season, hopefully, if I can put on the size for it. So I'm ready.
Any injuries?
No, never.
So how did you attain this level of Viking gargantuan
genetic
status without
thick,
a single scratch or wound on a tendon or ligament?
Thick ligaments.
I'm over here every other week, snap, 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 fracture, dislocate, herniate. It's almost like it's like a rhythm, it's like a song. It's unfortunate. So we finish up the workout and Kyle's like, pancakes, French toast, hydrogenated oils, refined sugar, calories, inflammation.
I thought we were going to smash some brunch. This man's like, oh, I know his spot, it's super clean. I'm like, what the hell?
Things have changed, Kyle. Times have evolved.
Dude,
health has
we
become
just
a priority.
A workout, you need some refill on the
isn't this your language though? Steak, rice, and greens?
Like
this is just archetypal bodybuilder meal. Like, are you like unaligning with it? I'm confused.
If you want to get technical, post workout, you're supposed to have no fats. So we're both breaking the law there. I mean, you're doing better than I am. I got some.
Yeah, what is this?
Well, it's grilled chicken. This is like a Greek dish, kind of. I don't know what that sauce is, but it looks good.
After this meal, there's a Denny's right around the corner.
Yeah,
that way, I'm gonna go
set
off.
You're gonna join me. We're gonna superset with Denny's, then we're gonna drop set
with a 72-hour fast. I'll be safe for the Denny's.
No, we're gonna drop set with some Dairy Queen.
Dairy Queen.
Yeah, and then we'll be ready for our leg workout tonight.
That I can't say that I fully align with that, but bodybuilder versus the spot.
Oh,
take
man
it down. Nothing but a peanut. Come on, Big Ron. Just take it down. One bite at a time. Let's bulk up now. You got an 800-pound set of squats for two. The Multiply squat suit tomorrow. You need the fuel. And you need a massive tan and maybe a Michael Jackson skin transplant. Look at me just being just vanilla clean over here. Just rice, steak, and green beans and water. This is just the epitome of just generic, bland bodybuilder lifestyle.
Who goes out to eat and eats like that? Eat that at home.
People that are committed, people that are dedicated,
oh,
people that
man
compete, succeed, and win. You wouldn't know about that, Kyle, because you eat fucking donuts and do squats and like don't get your tendons hurt.
But
I'm over here trying to win the Olympia.
You eat so clean, yet get injured.
Because I train harder than you, that's why I push the limits.
True.
You're a good actor, right? You're like a Jack Brad Pitt. You go in the gym and you put on an Oscar. I go in, authentically injure myself, and go all out. It's just how it is.
You salted it too much. You're not going to have a good workout.
We have the unfortunate sight of Island Gym closed until maybe some other place opens up there. Back in the day, that actually used to be a powerhouse gym far, far before I even had an ounce of muscle on my body. But luckily, rock bottom is still, it's clinging on. It's still there. Let's keep that going. James, this is my friend Kyle.
We are well acquainted.
I want you to sell me something that makes me look vaguely his size.
Like food?
Wow, it's going to be a potent session today. A little bit of hydraulic acid or whatever. It's a big scary word.
What kind of witchcraft is this?
All right. Ooh.
It works better if you turn it all the way up first.
James, we're not going to do that. Not a shot.
It was funny. I got those phosphines in front of my eyes the first time I turned it back on
again. I would not be surprised. Okay.
What are you saying? Who won the election?
Biden got announced as winner. Trump did investigation. Supreme Court ruled in his favor. It turns out he's the president. The world's losing their minds. Riots going everywhere. People losing their shit. I'm leaving the states. And I'm also increasing the voltage to 2.
How long do we have?
How long do we have?
Yeah.
Until the world is burning. Until the world's burning? I mean, the mind calendar was off. I mean, I have more insight now because I'm really tapped in. So I'd say maybe, like, we got, like, 2 more years, I'd say, roughly.
Okay.
Okay. Really kick it up there. Ooh, I'm tasting copper. Oh, God. Ooh, James, this is a new machine. Did you upgrade the batteries here? Like...
Yeah, I felt it, too.
Oh, my God. Ooh.
I think since you're not used to anymore.
Let's hit it. Bam. Okay, we're at max. Oh, my mouth is bleeding.
Where are we at?
2? It's at 2, but it's going to creep up to like 2.5, but it's maxed out at 5.
Maxed out at
2. I'll push it.
It can.
And I'll show you, because I have the insights, mystically. Okay. And you guys have seen too much, so we're going to end it there.
Theoretically, if you went shooting with this on, you'd shoot better.
James, the camera's rolling. I need you to explain to everyone. What is this weird witchcraft I have on my face skull?
Theoretically, it's called TDCS, transcranial direct current stimulation. So basically, what it's going to do is put an electric current into certain parts of your brain to do certain types of things. In this particular case, it's supposed to create like a flow state for you.
Flow state.
So you should just feel smoother. And if you were doing something that required some kind of learning, especially something...
What was that study they did with the video game guns or whatever? What was that?
Yeah, they just studied with DARPA that was pretty neat, where they brought a woman in who had never fired an assault rifle before. And they put her in this scenario with almost like a... Like, imagine a room being a giant video game where she's like a checkpoint in Iraq. Mm-hmm. They show her how to fire the gun. They have all these people coming at her, suicide bombers or whatever, and they see how she does. And she did terrible. She kept jamming the gun up, whatever. Then they said that she said they turned a switch on, and it was like a light switch going off. All of a sudden, her brain just went smooth, and she got a near-perfect score.
Interesting.
Yeah. And apparently, the next couple days afterwards, she just felt like she was just completely in a flowing state. Like, everything worked better for a couple days. So theoretically, it probably worked better for your brain if you were doing something. Do you mean... Yeah.
James, what on earth is happening on planet Earth right now, particularly in the West, particularly in the United States, particularly from a political lens? What is happening right now?
Well, apparently, Nevada only has one person that counts all the votes, and I believe...
One person?
She is a senior citizen.
What?
That doesn't see well. And that's why it's taking so long to process the votes in Nevada. She's got to do each one individually and then check to make sure she...
Now, James, I don't know how you feel about that personally, but I find that to be just ridiculous. Just malarkey, unscrupulous, unacceptable, just messed up.
I mean, it doesn't look very good for Trump right now, honestly, just looking at the whole thing.
Do you think there's some fraudulence happening when it comes to the counting of particularly mail-in ballots? What likelihood of fraudulence do you think there is?
Let's say the biggest fraudulence usually is ballots that don't get counted.
Mm-hmm.
So in that situation, that probably is true. There are ballots that probably don't get counted because I think that's happened in every election. Though, if they look for stuff, they find a box of ballots that don't get counted, or they were damaged or something. In this particular case, though, that would usually break for Biden. So Trump wouldn't want mail-in ballots to be counted, really. Do you mean? Because they've been traditionally breaking towards Biden the entire time.
So what do you think is, I mean, I'm not that politically inclined. I really haven't seen that many debates, et cetera, yada, yada. But to my knowledge, this is the first presidential debate where one of the candidates, like, just went out of their way to really talk about the potential corruption when it comes to the mail-in ballots. Now, do you think it's just like...
Well, I think he's setting the stage for...
What is happening now?
Yeah. It's kind of like when he comes out immediately. I think he even said this in one of his conversations. He goes, if I accuse the media of fraud early on, this is like back in 2016, if I say that they're doing fake news, it automatically casts doubt on anything that they do. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It makes anything that they do towards me look fake. It's actually not a bad technique. If I say John is a liar early, before he starts saying anything, then people are predisposed to think that John's a liar.
So, James, in your humble opinion, right, just statistically, like, just who do you think is going to win? Not who you want to win or don't want to win. Who do you think a year from now is going to be ruling in the Iron Throne of West, I mean, the United States?
You know what? I really don't know. I mean, looking by the numbers right now, I would have had to say Biden, just because that's what it looks like on my screen. But, I mean, he was supposed to win by a landslide, too, in the election, and the points are nowhere near what they said it was going to be.
James, how much androgens and amphetamines and other ridiculous compounds do you think Joe Biden is under the influence of while having a debate?
They probably just give him something that's similar to, like, an amphetamine.
Like a methamphetamine?
Yeah, I'm thinking probably they give him, like, a modafinil or something like that, maybe.
Interesting.
Increase alertness.
Interesting.
But again, maybe they don't. Maybe it's just adrenaline that keeps them up and a cup of coffee. That's a lot of adrenaline you're in front of the TV, you know what I mean?